What is up, guys? This is Godzilla Suplex, and welcome to today's episodes. I'll be discussing the future of WWE 2K. Where do they go from here? What's going to be their next game? And how do I think they should go about shaking out some of these issues that have happened in the fallout of WWE 2K20? Please hit that like and subscribe button if you want more content like this. And guys, let's get into it. We all know the dumpster fire that was WWE 2K20. Unlike wrestling games like WWE 2K14 and those that have come before it, the whole series, as really a whole since Visual Concepts has taken over, has been just plain awful. Or at the best, from WWE 2K16 to 19 has been decent, but not enough to really write home about. And WWE 2K20 was just a dumpster fire. The second worst maybe to WWE 2K15, which was awful in itself. So the series has really just grinded to a halt. And now we got news, it's official. WWE 2K21 is officially canceled and is off the table. And it's been replaced by WWE Battlegrounds, an arcade version of a game that looks like the developers who made it slapped it together in 5 minutes. I'm gonna get y'all into that, but first let's talk about what they should do. Okay, they cancel 2K21, and now let's look forward to WWE 2K22. Or you know what? Let's just scrap that, because I think I would give them an extra year. So I'm just gonna make, what do they need to do in my mind to make a good wrestling game from this point on, taking 2 or 3 years to make this game? First, I think WWE should give the rights to EA as an extra holder, and maybe some other studios, have them make their own version of wrestling games. So each year, each quarterly year, they have a wrestling game coming out by a different developer. I think that will greatly increase the value of WWE games. Each developer would have to gain the fans, because the year before, or something that may have came out earlier in the year, they're gonna have to somewhat compete with that on a bi-yearly basis. So doing that will put more pressure on 2K to make a better quality wrestling game. And when we get better quality wrestling games, the fans come back, the casuals come back and play it, they think it's fun, the game lives on longer, and so on and so forth. So with this next wrestling installment, presumably 2K23 or whatever the name they changed it to at the time, they would have to implement a competent, first of all, let's just get this off the top, and everybody says it, they have to have a GM mode. I don't think there's any way to get around it. People are asking for it. Universe mode, while it made a huge amount of improvements in previous installments, especially in 2K20, having though the different pay-per-view matches, as me as a Universe mode fan, they need to go ahead and combine it with GM mode, or put GM mode in Universe mode to make it really one of the staple modes of that certain video game. They could take a whole team, maybe 6 people, have them just develop universe mode in year 2 after they get done with the core mechanics in year 1. And this is why having that 3-year development cycle is so important, because they can work on core mechanics, moves, and basic wrestling animations in year 1, other features in year 2, and polishing for year 3. So that would be just a great cycle for a wrestling game. And then having, you know, the presumed story modes, and then the career mode, which they could heavily refine. Then having live service elements to it, you know, not that much, but DLC characters. And then having those DLC characters between all those 3 years, because we know we're going to miss 3 different eras of wrestling. And it's going to be kind of, you know, it's not going to be very good not having a wrestling game for each of those years. But just to have a quality product representing those 3 years of WWE, maybe having some stories from the previous 2 years, and then having that year be DLC, then getting some new characters, this would greatly boost the value of that game and its longevity in the eyes of the fans. Having and a lot of their problems, right, it's just not enough content. Because imagine you had a animation for everything, you have a story with crazy over the top elements like WWE originals, but more wider in scope and more built into the game. You know, you have a more arcadey, fun gameplay that makes sense. Or it could be a semi-competitive fighting game instead of being this weird, is it fake, is it real? and type stuff, so it could be competitive. They could take the payback system and really expound it, making exclusive paybacks for each character in the game, really boosting the competitiveness, making online a viable option, and making it fun to really master this wrestling game and mimic the real life product. Plus, since it's been 3 years, the jump would be so big that it would get all the attention in the gaming and wrestling industry. Everybody would flock to this game, and it would give the developers enough time. It would give everybody just something, especially if it came out to really good reviews. It would just shake up the wrestling world, and to know they would go into development for 3 more years, it would get people excited and bring back story mode and all these things they could do, you know, to really help the 2K YouTubers, okay? Because those guys keep the game alive, they keep people watching, and anything they add in that game that can help them entertain their fan base and keep the game alive has to be utmost priority, right? Really below the gameplay and all the other stuff, but that should be at the back of 2K's head to do. So they did all that kind of stuff into a, you know, back to traditional wrestling fun game. I think that would go over very well with the fans, would be popular, and it would stay on top. But now let's get to another subject that would happen, or is happening right now, and that is that WWE is releasing this Battlegrounds game. Now, I'm gonna have footage up there, but guys, I gotta rip into this one. Like, what the fudge is this? What the heck am I looking at? This game looks like it was brought together by an indie team. And they're saying that this team has been working on this game for 2 or a couple of years, whatever that means. Like, maybe not 2, maybe 1.5, but however long. When the heck is this? Like, it looks like it's a mobile game that has been slightly upgraded to just meet the console requirements. I mean, this is just looks bare bones. I'm looking at it. It does. It looks like, you know, a little game that you would give your 5-year-old kid. And people are saying, oh, at least it's not WWE Superstars. Let me tell you something. If they made a remake or any kind of sequel to WWE Superstars, that junk would be lit. WWE Superstars is one of the most litest games and one of probably the greatest wrestling concept games to never get a sequel. Had they made that now with a full roster universe mode, it would be better than any WWE 2K game has ever been made. By miles. By miles. Not even close. Especially WWE 2K20. It would be miles ahead. You give the same feature set to WWE All-Stars with its fun gameplay and just high octane action, over the top, you know, moves. That game is GOAT. Like, I'm sorry. And for anybody that's hating on it, you know, it's like WWE Battlegrounds is like this little smaller kiddier version, and really just tell the truth, less produced and less costly version of that game. And it just disappoints me on so many levels, because you could do so much with the WWE All-Star sequel. Like, this game could, you could add elimination chamber, all types of match types, throw people around, make different styles, make different archetypes for each character, have the bring in the payback system for different characters. You know, there's so much that they can improve to make that in the same quality of vein of a WWE 2K game, but just with the gameplay style of WWE All-Stars. And just that would just be just out of this world, and it would just boost 2K to just unreal heights, because they have the rights to it, but they just won't do it, and it just surprised me so much. So now we have to worry about the future of 2K, because guess what? They got competition now. Yuka's talking about making an AEW game. And we already know that AEW is already making a game, but is Yuke's behind it? We do not know. Yuke's could be, well, they said they're making their own rival wrestling game, but it's like, the world is kind of looking bleak for these guys, right? They make the worst wrestling game in the past decade, next to W2K15. Then, the people that helped them make the game previous year, which I still have W2K19, they're going over to work for somebody else to make another wrestling game, and now you're stuck with this team who just made the worst possible wrestling game of the decade, and now the people that helped you make the actual good wrestling games are gone. They're gone. They're helping somebody else now. Potentially AEW could be making a great game and making a splash. And how embarrassing would that be if AEW in their first go around beats everything you've worked on for the past 4 or 5 years? That wouldn't look good. And the potential of this is very high, because Yuke's has been in this thing for like nearly 20 years. Any other developers, maybe the Fire Pro Wrestling developers or anybody like that that's made wrestling games or just want to come over to wrestling games, can make a big splash now that 2K is in such a weakened state and actually bring a good wrestling game experience to the forefront of the wrestling video game industry. And it just does look bleak for 2K staying in the game. And if I'm WWE, I'm cutting up that exclusive deal and looking for a new developer to split the responsibilities with 2K and Visual Concepts, because they are obviously inept at doing their job. They have not made a good wrestling game since they have taken over, and the first game they do take over in, it's a complete dumpster fire. So it's like, okay, let's try EA, let's try scrounge with some developers over there and give them the rights to our game and have these guys alternate Call of Duty style, so we can have constantly a great wrestling game coming out every year that has a good 3-year cycle. And with that, I think that WWE could really fix this problem of having quality control issues involving their wrestling games. But guys, this has been the best Gojira in gaming news, guys. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell so you get a notification every time I make a video. And you guys have a nice day.